Hi, it's Kim from Chatterbox Quilts. Today, I'm taking a look at a product I got recently called the Grip and Press. It's from Bare Thread Designs. They're the same people who make the applique pressing sheet that I love so much. Now, this is a little sheet here, 12.5 by 17 inches, and you can see that it's silver on the one side. That's the part you're going to press on, and the other side is black. That's a grippy part. So what this does, it allows you to put this down on just about any surface and transform it into an ironing surface. Now, having said that, I don't know that I would put it down on my cutting mat. I'd be a little hesitant about doing that because I think it might melt it. I don't know for sure. And if you want to try it out and let me know how it goes, you can do so and let me know in the comments below. But I would suggest you put it on a surface that you're not worried in case the heat doesn't work so well with that surface. Okay, so having said that, you can put it down, and because it's got that rubber backing, it's going to stick. And I have some fabric here I want to press. So the top part here is slippery, like an ironing board surface that you want to have, because you want to be able to move the iron around, right? If it was rubbery on the top, you wouldn't be able to move the iron around. That wouldn't work so well. So I actually have it on a pressing surface right now. I just wanted to make sure it would stick to things. And you can see I can use it and move my iron around no problem. Now, after I'm done ironing, the surface of it is going to be hot, okay? Again, like the applique pressing sheet, you want to let it cool off a bit before you pick it up. So it's great for a pressing surface, and how would you use this? Well, when you go to retreats, right? If you want to take your own iron and you don't want to have to lug a pressing surface with you, you can just take the grip and press with you. It rolls up. That's how you're going to store it. You're not going to fold it, but you're going to roll it all up and take it with you. And you want to make sure that you're pressing on the silver side. Do not press on the rubber side. I don't think that would work very well. And there's lots of other things you can do with this too. So besides using it as a pressing surface, it has a non-stick top, right? So if you want to do any fabric painting using acrylic paints, let's say, you could actually use this as a palette. So you could put your acrylic paints down here and you can work with them on your fabric. And then when you want to clean this off, just let the paints dry a bit and they'll just peel off and you can just take them right off. Having said that, you can also do the same thing if you are using fusible web. So sometimes when you're using fusible web and it's on just your regular ironing board, maybe some of the fusible part, the web part, gets on your ironing surface and then it's going to stick to it. And you don't want that. It's going to wreck your ironing surface. And it's going to activate the next time you heat it up again too. So you don't want it getting stuck to pieces of fabric if that wasn't your intention. So this also works really well if you're using fusible web. So you could actually put your pieces on here that you want to, your fabric pieces that you want to press the fusible web to. And that way, if there's any overlap of the fusible web and it gets on here, same thing, it's just going to peel right off. You'll just be able to scrape it off and it'll come off very easily. So those are some of the other uses for this. It's almost like a little craft mat that you can use too. So if you have kids at home doing different crafts and painting, the grip and press will work really well for that as well. If you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you're not already a subscriber to the Chatterbox Quilts YouTube channel, I'd love it if you would subscribe, and you'll get fresh new content from us every week.